I think I'm just gonna start. My name is Kurt. Hello. I'm also a Planet Fitness Black Card member. You can see this is a picture of me hugging a Planet Fitness employee. After I found out they have they allow transgender people to use whatever bathroom they want. So that's pretty tight. I am also looking for my wife. Not really sure where she is. I haven't seen her for a really long time. She's a really good hider. So if you find her, let me know. I am also a sensitive white male. As you can see from this photo, my eyes are usually watery. I have rosy cheeks most of the time because I'm usually pretty embarrassed. And I have pock marks on my skin from severe anxiety and depression. Trying to learn how to live with that, but I gotta admit, it is getting better every day, so that's nice. So I'm just gonna play my next song.
Oh,
as I said before, I am indeed a sensitive white man. And as such, I love telling people what to do. So please, everybody, take out your phones. I can wait. Take out your phones. It's okay. No one's going to hurt you. Let's have them. Come on. Verizon, T-Mobile, whatever you got. Sprint. I don't really prefer to use Sprint, but that's just me. So this is a portion of the program where I tell all y'all about some people that I think are really important to follow that you may not know about. This is Sean King. He's leader of the Injustice Boycott Movement. He is a activist and a journalist, really trying to get people out into the streets and off of their screens and trying to do actual work to foment real change. So Sean King is a really great person to follow. And then we also have Sarah Kendzior. She's an author and a journalist on authoritarian states. And she's one of the only people that is actually telling it like it is, so to speak, and getting people to actually pay attention to what's really going on. And no bullshit from Sarah Kendzior, and really, really good person to follow to find what's actually going on. And this is R. Ariel. She's an amazing musician from Los Angeles and really, really a good activist type person. Really, really honest and really, really real and upfront. Really good at getting people to get in touch with their emotions and get in touch with the feelings that they feel and feel okay and comfortable expressing them, which I think is really important. So I'm going to tell you a bit about myself real quick. I love feelings. So this is a record that I have for sale. It's a record that was recorded inside of a cave. It's a split with my good friend Nora. She's an amazing folk singer and really, really great person and really, really great musician. And all the money for that goes to the Standing Rock Legal Defense. This is a picture of me in a cowboy hat holding a bag of Frito Scoops. A stranger gave me a phone call and said that I'm the reason that they didn't kill themselves. And so I said, wow, that's amazing. I'm so glad that you decided to live. And I thought that they would really like it if I sent them a funny pic. And this is what I was doing at the time. So I sent it to them, and they're doing just fine, everybody. And this is a picture of my diploma from the University of Northern Iowa. We got a fellow alumnus here. I have a Bachelor of Arts in Jazz Studies. And if you're paying attention, you'll notice that there's no toilet paper on the toilet paper roll. But thankfully, because of my Bachelor of Arts in Jazz Studies, I know how to improvise. And lastly, this is a picture of me in the tub. Me in the tub. So we're going to switch gears real quick and talk a little bit about toxic masculinity, everybody. Toxic masculinity. So I have a little video for you, a little presentation that kind of shows what can happen when people try to not really understand how to listen to people and how to talk to people and how to be a good person. So here we go.
I got no good ideas. I'm confident.
Hey, let's like be more than friends. Yeah. And let's just like.
Stuff, huh? So, I think one thing that we can learn from the scene, this scenario here, is the things that toxic masculinity does to people. Toxic masculinity, first and foremost, silences people. It keeps people from expressing their emotions and keeps people from feeling the things that they feel and telling people about the things that they feel, which leads people to repress their emotions. And because people are repressing their emotions and not expressing themselves in the fullest and complete way that they can, that leads to very destructive patterns that just kind of affect everyone and affect entire cultures and societies. And I think it's a thing that everybody needs to be aware of. To that end, I want to lead everybody in a group meditation. I want to get everybody in touch with their feelings and feeling the things that they feel. And I want people to listen to the people around them. And I want people to listen to somebody that you probably don't listen to very much, probably don't pay attention to, and that's yourself. So I'm going to lead everybody in a group meditation here. Now listen to yourself and listen to how you're feeling. So we're going to breathe in with me and then breathe out with the flute. Really simple stuff here. So everybody can just breathe in with me. Breathe in.
good boy. And we had to put him down last August. And it's been really weird trying to live in a world without him. The last year before his life, my life kind of revolved around his life. And so not having him here has been pretty weird, but I kind of have been figuring out how to process my emotions about it, and one of the ways that I like to do that is by making music. And so I made a song for my little boy Sam, and I'll play it for you just as soon as I get this bad boy tuned up.
Six billion. it's simple.